So now the third component of the circulatory system is the heart. But before studying the structure of heart, let me explain here. This closed circulation is further studied into two types as the single circulation and that of double circulation. In vertebrates, like lower vertebrates and higher vertebrates. In lower vertebrates, like for example, fishes, the circulation is single circulation. That is, the blood flows only once, and therefore such circulatory system shows the single circulation as in the due course of evolution. We studied that on the basis of the structure of heart, as in the lower vertebrate like fish, the heart is two chambered with one atria and one ventricle. I think if you remember, last year you studied the circulatory system circulates the blood as venous blood. So what type of circulation is observed in fishes? The venous blood is circulated, is transported. Such type of circulation as when the stream of blood flows only once is referred as single circulation. So what should be double? The flow of the blood is twice, and here blood passes through the heart twice. So in single circulation, blood will pass towards the heart at once, and therefore how come the circulation is? The flow of venous blood in fishes is the deoxygenated blood from the heart passes to the gills, because the respiratory organs in the fishes, as they are aquatic, so in aquatic animal the respiratory organs are gills, and therefore in the gills the blood gets oxygenated, and on oxygenation the blood moves towards the various parts of the body, and at the same time when oxygenated blood is transported, it passes through different parts of the body, the deoxygenated blood is taken out, and this deoxygenated blood returns back to the heart for next cycle. So this is the flow of the blood which happens as in the single circulation. Are you getting my point? Here the type of blood which flows to the heart is what type of blood? It is deoxygenated. So it is venous blood. And from heart again, the blood will go towards the lungs for purification, for oxygenation, and then it will move to various parts and will take and return, what we can say, the blood which will return back will be in the form of deoxygenated. And this deoxygenated blood, when returns back to the heart, again the second cycle will begin. Such type of circulation is called as the single circulation. Whereas, as from the Pisces, the next animals which were evolved were the amphibians. Amphibians, example, heart. How many chamber heart is in amphibians? Like frog, heart is three chamber with two atria and one ventricle. In reptiles, the heart is imperfectly four-chambered. Does not consist of two chambers as perfect ventricles. Such type of heart is called as imperfect. Whereas in apes and in mammals, apes, those are birds, mammals, we can take the example of human beings, human. What type of circulation is? Here the heart is perfectly four-chambered. This four chamber divides our heart into two equal halves, the right side and the left side. So the two streams of the blood will simultaneously flow, and the blood flow will be taking place how many times to the heart? Twice. Such type of circulation is called as double circulation. This double circulation further is the first as pulmonary circulation and the second as systemic circulation. What kind of the roots are? The root as pulmonary refers to, just now I explained, pulmonary ka matlab lungs. So here, how is the root? From heart to the lungs and from lungs to the heart. But try to understand, these are the two streams of the blood. Deoxygenated blood from heart will be transported to the lungs for purification, as from the right ventricle paralyzes the pulmonary arteries. Pulmonary arteries carry deoxygenated blood. So from heart, the deoxygenated blood will be passing towards lungs, and in the lungs, the blood will get oxygenated. And when the blood is oxygenated from lungs, once again, it will return towards the heart. But what form of the blood it is? It is the oxygenated blood from lungs to the heart. So, those are the pulmonary veins which will carry the blood from lungs to the heart. And from heart, this purified blood, oxygenated blood will go to different parts of the body. Are you getting how is the road? From heart to the lungs and from lungs to the heart. The stream of the blood is from heart, deoxygenated will go towards the lungs for purification. Once purified in the lungs, again it will come towards the heart. And from heart, it will be transported to different parts of the body. The route is just from heart to lungs. Understood? Whereas, when you will study the structure of heart, you will come to know what are the various parts of the heart which makes the transport. But here, just try to understand, the pulmonary route is from heart to lungs and from lungs to heart. Then, what is the second route? The second route is the systemic route. The systemic route is the systemic, systemic circulation. The systemic circulation means the blood from various parts of the body is brought towards the heart through the blood vessels like superior vena cava and inferior vena cava. Both superior and inferior will bring blood from different parts of the body. So what sort of the blood should be? It is a deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood is poured, is released in the heart, and now from heart, where it will go? This will not be the pulmonary, try to understand. We are discussing about systemic. So systemic circulation is from different parts of the body to heart. Where from different parts of the body to heart and from heart to different parts of the body. So superior and inferior vena cava will collect the deoxygenated blood from different parts of the body towards the heart. That's all. And the oxygenated blood from the heart will be transported to different parts of the body. What type of blood will be taken from heart to different parts of the body? Oxygenated. So I mean, in short, the pulmonary circulation is from heart to lungs, whereas systemic circulation is from different parts of the body to heart and from heart to different parts of the body, the two streams of the blood. So this makes you to understand the single circulation and that of double circulation. Is that clear? Understood all of you?